This is Loren Lockman coming to you from the Tanglewood Wellness Center in Costa Rica. So I've been asked a question, and the question is, what actually happens to our bodies, in our bodies, when we begin fasting? Because although our bodies in every single moment of our lives are attempting to cleanse and heal themselves as well as they possibly can, it's not until we're actually fasting that the most powerful processes begin to happen. And the first thing that happens is, because the body is always governed by the law of efficiency, the first 8 to 12 hours, when the body needs calories or nutrients, it's going to go to the digestive tract. Now, by the time it's 8 to 12 hours into the process, that is from your last meal, there really won't be anything valuable left in the digestive tract. And so at that point in time, the body goes to the liver. Now, the one thing that the body always needs to have, and you know, this is 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, 366 days on leap years, is we need to have glucose. The brain needs glucose. And so glycogen is a glucose precursor, and we store glycogen in the liver. But there's only, again, about a 8 to 12 hour supply most of the time. So by the time we're anywhere from 16 to 24 hours after our last meal, our bodies have now depleted the glycogen reserves in the liver, and they're now looking for the next most efficient source of fuel. If we had it our way, if we could choose, that would be long-term fat stores, adipose tissue. Unfortunately, we don't get to choose. The body is choosing because it's looking for the most efficient way to get this need met. And the most efficient way is not by breaking down fat, because fat, whether it's dietary fat that we're consuming or it's our own body fat, breaking down fat requires a lot of energy. It's not a good way to create energy because it takes a lot of energy. What's much more efficient is converting muscle tissue into fuel. And there is no sugar available in muscle tissue, but there is a process called gluconeogenesis. It's a chemical conversion process where the body is actually able to take tiny amounts of muscle and convert it into sugar. So, by the time we deplete all the liver's glycogen reserves, our body is now in this stage where we are converting muscle into sugar. And how long that happens depends on your body composition. So, for someone who has relatively little muscle on the body, it won't take as long to deplete all the muscle the body wants to deplete, that the body's willing to deplete. For someone who has much greater muscle mass relative to their overall mass, then the body will stay in this process a little bit longer. Typically, by the time someone is about 3 days until they're about 5 days after their last meal, the body is going to be in this process of using primarily muscle to convert it to sugar to get the body's glucose needs met. When it gets to a certain point, and again, how long this takes depends on your body composition, when it gets to a certain point, your body, which we call the protein sparing point, your body says, okay, hang on a second, there's still no food coming in, no more fuel coming in, I don't want to lose any more muscle tissue. At that point, what happens is the body goes to a less efficient but safer long-term source of fuel, and that would be adipose tissue. This is our long-term fat stores. And so it's critically important to understand that this process only happens in the absence of nutrients. If we're consuming calories or nutrients, it's not happening. So if we're drinking juices, if we're taking supplements, if we're using herbs, we're not getting this process. It's not happening this way. And you know, many people hear about this whole crazy idea, going weeks without food, that sounds, you know, radical. And what they fail to realize, remember, is that the one reason that we carry body fat on our bodies, I mean, we need a tiny amount of fat in order to survive. Roughly 2 to 2.5% is considered essential body fat. Now, some people would say, well, for a woman, it's more like 12%. But what they're really talking about is, for a woman, in order for her to be able to conceive, she needs to have at least 12 or so percent body fat. But that's hardly what I would call essential. You know, essential is life or death, right? And it's the same for men and women. So essential fat is 2 to 2.5%. Why then is the average person walking around with upwards of 30% body fat today? Why does that happen? Well, the answer is obviously because of what people are eating and because of how much exercising they're doing or not doing. But also, the reason the body stores this stuff is because in nature, there are periods of feast and famine. There are floods and droughts and fires and other times when there may not be food available. And so animals in nature store fat on their bodies so they have something to sustain themselves when they can't eat. Many people think if they skip lunch, they'll probably die, right? But the fact is that the average person's got between 6 and 8 weeks worth of reserves that they're walking around with right now. And you know, we're now 60-some percent overweight, and a great percentage of those people are obese today in the United States. Many of those people have months worth of reserves, literally. Okay, literally, they're walking around with months worth of reserves, all the calories they could possibly need. And the interesting thing is, all the nutrients they need too. Now, this is surprising to many people because, you know, most people would imagine that if you're not eating, how could you possibly get the nutrients that you need, right? You'd run out of nutrients. I just got a question this morning saying, well, yeah, this sounds great, but aren't you going to wind up with malnutrition if you go very long? And the answer is no. And it's an interesting thing, but I have seen in the 15 years I've been supervising fasts, I've seen numerous occasions where people came in with deficiencies. Potassium, magnesium, vitamin B12, iron, other deficiencies. And what happens is, while fasting and consuming only pure water, those deficiency conditions are resolved. The deficiencies go away. Well, how's that possible? Well, as far as I can tell, the only way that's possible is if the nutrients were already in the body, but unable to assimilate them. Fasting allowed the body to become efficient enough to be able to use what was already there. And so I've never seen anybody wind up with a deficiency disease, deficiency condition as a result of fasting. In fact, there was one time where this happened, but it wasn't because of fasting. It was because the woman in question, who had had her thyroid surgically removed 60 years earlier, was not taking thyroid hormone when she needed to be taking thyroid hormone every single day for the rest of her life, because her body could never produce any more. The thyroid governs the body's potassium, and so potassium and sodium need to stay in balance. Without thyroid hormone, you've got a sodium and potassium problem. And we wound up needing to take her to the hospital, but it was only because she hadn't taken her thyroid hormone for weeks, and I didn't know this, and she hadn't told me this. I told her just the opposite. You need to take it every single day. In fact, we contacted her sister, who runs a clinic in California, to let her know that her twin sister was in the hospital. And her sister said, oh, this is the third time she's done this. So I've never seen a single person become deficient. It's one of those things you'll hear people say, you're gonna wind up with electrolyte problems. It doesn't happen.